Hello YouTube, it's Anas here on Watch On channel. Today the full review of this watch. I already did a first impressions unboxing video of this watch, and as you can see, it's a Squale. So Squale or Squale, but I'm going to call it Squale, and that means something like shark in Italian. And this is kind of a controversial watch in some communities within the watch world, because it's been really, really pushed by another watch channel, and he even got his own personal design of this brand. This one was bought through Gnomon Watches in Singapore. It's not a totally original design, but it's an interesting watch, and it's really surprising in many ways, and that's in positive ways. So I decided to test out the watch instead of just believing everything I read online. So it comes in this blue cardboard box, and then inside you find this nice blue leather watch roll with the Squale name and the logo kind of embossed or branded into the leather. And there you find the warranty card, the hang tag. You also find the manual for the watch, nothing too interesting. And here you find the watch. So this is the Squale Y1545, and this is kind of a vintage inspired Squale model. What they did with this watch was trying to make a vintage inspired kind of sea dweller meets Submariner, but still it has its own life because it doesn't have the same handset as the Rolex watches, and it's also kind of a mismatch between those two watches. So it kind of gets its own life, although it's of course quite inspired by the Rolex watches. What we get is of course an automatic watch, and it does have some very nice modern dimensions, approximately 40 millimeters in diameter, including the crown. You get 44, a thickness of approximately 12.5 to 13 millimeters, lock tip to lock tip 47. It's very nice with the lock width of 20 millimeters because it's very easy to find other straps, NATO straps, and whatever you want to put on this watch. But it really comes on a super nice bracelet. So having a closer look at the dial, we get these printed big loom markings with this kind of vintage inspired old radium luminova. And then you get the Squale logo at 12 o'clock with the name and the logo. At 3 o'clock, a date window, which like on the Sea Dweller is without a Cyclops. And let me just show you down here at 6 o'clock. So 20 atmospheres, the Y1545 Squale, Swiss made. That's all of the printing you get on the dial. So you get this kind of deep black, but a little grayish dial color. And then you get these old sword hands, which we saw on the very old mill sub watches. I really like that they decided to not put on the Mercedes hands, because that would just be too much of a blatant Rolex inspiration. With this one, it keeps kind of its own design cues, although of course it is inspired by Rolex. It has a 120 click unidirectional bezel, which is absolutely amazing. Absolutely no play. Very easy to grip because of the coin etching here, and the feeling and the sound is just really, really good with this one. The bezel insert is a ceramic black bezel insert with a kind of faux vintage loom pip at 12 o'clock, and then you get silver printing. Looks really, really nice. You get a very nice, slightly domed sapphire crystal, which is treated with AR, so it's not too hard to read in the direct sunlight. Looking at the case, we get polish on the sides, a typical Rolex-inspired, Submariner-inspired case. So polishing on the sides, very big, nice signed crown. This is one of my favorite things with this watch. It's this big crown because it's really easy to grip, and I really just like the functionality and the look of a big crown on a watch. So on the other side, of course, also polished, and on the upper side, this kind of light brushing. The bracelet is a typical oyster style bracelet, brushing on top, polished on sides. Very nice detail is that it's screwed pins, so it's very, very easy to adjust this bracelet. The clasp is just a simple fold over clasp, Squale logo on the clasp, and then you just open. Also very nicely, it's milled metal, not stamped metal, which is a big plus. And looking at the case back, it's not the most interesting case back on this watch. So Squale Y1545 stainless steel, sapphire crystal, 20 atmospheres, which is 200 meters of water resistance, solid end links as well. Inside of this watch is the ETA 2824-2. It's really accurate. As you can see on your screen now, I get 4 to 5 seconds plus, which is within COSC certification. So that's really, really nice. A big plus and a big applause to Squale for making this watch so accurate. It really just maybe suggests that they actually regulate the movements before they send out the watches, which is a very big plus. Also, the lume is absolutely amazing. I have heard some criticism about the lume on the Squale watches, but this is absolutely amazing, as you can see on the screen. No complaints whatsoever, really, really nice lume. On my 18 centimeter wrist in circumference, it just really fits well. It is quite the heavy watch. It definitely is a watch that you notice when you're wearing it. It's quite heavy, but I can easily pull it off, as you can see. And it wears really comfortable and really, really nicely. And it just really is this big kind of tool watch, dive watch. It really has some wrist presence. So definitely a good watch. The bracelet is absolutely nice. It's definitely just like wearing a high quality Oyster style bracelet, in my opinion. So getting into the pluses and the minuses of this watch. Let's start with the minuses. It is, of course, a Rolex-inspired watch, and that's kind of a minus in my book because I really enjoy original designs much more than Omaz watches. And there's no coming around, this is kind of an Omaz watch. But I think they did a really good job because they didn't do just a very boring Omaz watch. They kind of took the old Millsap Submariners and the Sea Dweller, and then they blended them together, and they made a really, really nice watch. All the stats are really, really good, so for approximately $600, you get a high quality Swiss watch. I would definitely recommend you buying this watch instead of a cheaper Japanese watch. Spend a couple of $100 more and then you get a much better watch, in my opinion. So that's kind of the elephant in the room. This is, of course, not a completely original design. So that's absolutely my biggest minus, because for the money you get a really nice watch. The bracelet is very nice, nice taper. It also has screwed pins. The clasp is definitely okay. It's not the best clasp in the universe, but you also get 4 micro adjustments. You get a ceramic bezel insert. You get absolutely amazing lume. You get a very highly accurate watch. So that's actually what you can just ask for with a dive watch or a tool watch: accuracy, toughness, and reliability. And you get all of that with this Squale Y1545, in my opinion. So it's all down to you guys. Would you buy a watch from a somewhat controversial brand? Or would you want to buy a watch that is not as inspired by Rolex and is from another brand? I definitely think that if you are looking at great dive watches, Swiss made, under $1,000, I can definitely recommend this watch. So is it staying in my collection? I'm not quite sure if this is staying in my collection. As you know, I have a lot of other dive watches, very cool dive watches. And I can't really get away from the fact that this is maybe a little too Rolex inspired for my taste. It's absolutely not a big problem, but if it was a more original design, I would definitely maybe keep this watch. But I think it has to go. I have really enjoyed owning this watch and wearing this watch and trying out a Squale watch and trying out a Swiss made watch in this price category. I hope you enjoyed the full review of the Squale watch. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Leave a comment down below. Is this too much of a Rolex homage, or could you wear this watch? And what do you think about the specifications and the accuracy compared to the price of $600? Also, are there other watches in the same category that you can recommend below or just around $600? Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Facebook, and I will see you very soon. Thank you. Bye.